Hello students, in this video we are going to see how to find inverse by using adjoint method for 2 by 2 and 3 by 3 matrices. So while computing inverse of any matrices or matrices of any order, you have to follow these steps for the adjoint method. Step number one, find, let A be given matrix then first step, find determinant of A, then if determinant of A is equal to 0, that means A inverse does not exist, because it is a singular matrix. But if, then again, if determinant of A is not equal to 0, then A inverse exists. In short, if a matrix is a non-singular matrix, then we'll get, or we can find, inverse of that matrix. And if the matrix is singular, the inverse of that matrix does not exist. So our first step while computing inverse of a given matrix, we have to consider the determinant first. We have to find out the determinant first and check that determinant is zero or non-zero. If it is non-zero, then we'll proceed further. In second step, find matrix of cofactors. Matrix of cofactors. For cofactors, we have to write down, or we have to compute minors first. So we'll also see what are, how to find minors also. So this is our second step. In third step, write down adjoint of given matrix. Adjoint of A is equal to transpose of cofactor matrix. Adjoint of A is equal to transpose of cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix is here. Cofactor matrix of A is AC. I have written it as AC. Now, after finding the adjoint of A, to find the determinant, to find the inverse of A, that is A inverse, is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. Adjoint of A, we have seen in the third step. So, this is a formula to find the inverse of a given matrix. So these are the steps. Now let's get started for the matrix of order 2 by 2 first. And in the next video, we will see how to find inverse for 3 by 3 matrices. So hope you like this video, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe and click on bell icon so that you can get a notification of all the videos we have uploaded. Consider this example. Let A is equal to 2, 4, 3, 3. Now first step is to find determinant. So determinant of A is equal to 6 minus 12 is equal to minus 6. So determinant of A is not equal to 0, it is minus 6. Therefore, A inverse exists because it is non-singular. Okay. Now, in the second step, find out minor sign cofactor matrix. Find out minors. We'll first compute minors. So, minor M11 is equal to, for minors, consider our matrix M11 means 11 position. Delete this row and this column and we'll get 3 as the remaining element. M12, delete this row and this column, we'll get this 3. Then M21, second row, first column, second row, first column, we'll get 4. And M22, second row, second column, we'll get remaining 2 here. Now, for cofactors, use this rule, minus 1 raised to I plus J into Mij. This cofactor, to find cofactor of Cij is equal to. In short, check the subscript of M11. 1 plus 1, we are getting 2. 1 plus 1, subscript. 1 plus 1, 2. Means, if the addition of this subscript or this index is even, then don't change the sign. M21, here you can see, M21, 2 plus 1, 3. So, in this case, we have to change the sign of this number. This is plus 4, we have to take it as minus 4. Now, this one, M12, 1 plus 2, 3. So, we have to take it as minus 3. M22, 2 plus 2, 4. We don't need to change the sign of this number. So, to find out cofactor, C11 is equal to 3. C12 is equal to minus 3. I have to change the sign for the cofactors. Then, M21 is equal to minus 4. And M22 is equal to 2. So the cofactor matrix is AC is equal to C11 is 3, C12 is minus 3, C21 is minus 4 and C22 is 2. So now find adjoint. Adjoint of A is nothing but transpose of cofactor matrix. So here is a cofactor matrix. I have to just transpose that matrix. 3 minus 4. I have to write down this column as row. Now this column is row, minus 3, 2. So this is our adjoint. To find A inverse, we have to just write down 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A, 3 minus 4 minus 3 into this gives us 1 upon determinant of A, our determinant is minus 6, I have to put minus 1 upon 6 also, 3 minus 4 minus 3, 2. So this is the answer for the given example. I'm going to give you a trick here. If a matrix of order 2 by 2, suppose A, B, C, D is given, then A inverse, if the determinant of A is not equal to 0, obviously, then A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into just mention, change the position of these diagonal elements. Here is A, I am writing here D, and this A here, and change the sign of diagonal element, minus B, minus C. So this is a shortcut formula to use in your entrance examination. By using this, you can get your answer in 5 seconds only. Shortcut. Remember, this will not work in your theory examination. You can use this shortcut method only in entrance examination or in solving aptitude test. If we check this formula is working or not, you can check by this example. 2, 4, 3, 3. In this case, we are getting minus 1 upon 6 by changing the positions of 3 and 2. In the original example, we have 2 here and 3 here. Here, A and D are interchanged, and the sign of these two numbers has been changed. So, this trick will work for every 2x2 matrices. Thank you.